Once upon a time, an amoeba split in two.
And then the two
amoebae created quite a few.
They continued procreating for the simple joy of mating,
'cause there really wasn't very much else to do. And before too long they grew into a multitude,
reproducing very quickly and collecting food.
Realizing all their wishes, they developed into fishes,
'cause a single cell amoeba was a bit too crude.
Then the fishes in the ocean swam about a bit,
till an enterprising haddock got fed up with it.
And he wandered on the beach until the sea was out of reach,
although he couldn't fathom out the land for all his wit.
That's when Mother Nature came in to intervene.
So she changed the fish to a lizard with a spleen,
gave him legs to walk around with and a voice to make a sound with,
and some lenses that would really make his eyesight keen.
And before too long his children were diversified.
They would generate, sophisticate and multiply,
and they grew and grew and grew into a prehistoric zoo,
until the rat became a bat who taught them how to fly.
And the rabbits were delighted when they came to be,
and the elephants were absolutely thrilled to see
mighty dinosaur and leopard, and the sheep without the shepherd,
and the pelican, the zebra and the chimpanzee.
Silently away,
and there were many creatures who met their dying day,
but the well-adapted ape was in the very best of shape to start a species that would give the others hell to pay.
And his name was Homo sapiens, the hunting man.
He was Adam, she was Eve, until the race began.
And the man was very brave, he dragged the woman to his cave,
where he presented her with babies and a frying pan.
And before too long he wrote himself an alphabet.
He invented jammy dodgers and the jumbo jet,
technologically contriving and successfully surviving
for the sake of vegetating on the internet.
Now those days are only history, and so are we, 'cause the women are the bosses and the men ain't free. So we'll blow ourselves to bits in Armageddon's mighty blitz, and then we'll realize the Superman was not to be.
So the story ends, and there's only one thing more.
There was a sole survivor who made it to the shore.
It was not the Queen of Sheba, but the very first amoeba, who began the whole creation like it did before.